The difficult-to-watch video of a football player punching a woman and knocking her out cold inside a hotel elevator tonight remains at the center of a growing conversation and controversy about domestic abuse and the big business that happens to be America's favorite sport, the NFL. And while it is hard to watch, it's also hard to believe the NFL never saw it until the rest of us did just yesterday. But the commissioner says tonight that is the case, and he now knows that every aspect of this case is being looked at all over again because of the widely held view that this was both a failure of the justice system and a failure of the sport. It's where we begin again tonight with NBC's Josh Elliott. He's live with us at NBC Sports Network headquarters. Josh, good evening.
Good evening to you, Brian. As you mentioned, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell reiterated late today that league officials never saw the video showing the altercation between Ray Rice and his now wife, Janae, until Monday. But the firestorm that tape has generated has the NFL scrambling still.
Football fans across the country reacting to the video showing the violent altercation between Ray Rice and his then fiance put their anger on display today. A fury directed at Rice and the NFL. The collective rallying cry, too little, too late. Videos such as this surfaced on social media of fans burning Ray Rice jerseys.
He doesn't deserve to be honored.
And that wasn't all. Nike, one of Rice's sponsors, terminated its contract with him. While the Ravens, as well as major sporting goods chains such as Dick's and Modell's, announced an exchange program allowing fans to return unwanted Rice jerseys.
And the give now to Ray Rice.
And EA Sports, the video game maker, announced it was pulling Rice's image from its best-selling Madden 15 football game, all while players from around the league tweeted their outrage. As players, we must speak up, stand up for what's right. This is way bigger than football. Don't be blind to what's really important. While Ray Rice's wife, Janae Rice, was angry as well, but for a different reason, posting on Instagram in part, "This is our life. What don't you all get? If your intentions were to hurt us, embarrass us, make us feel alone, take all happiness away, you've succeeded on so many levels." And for the first time since the tape's release, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell addressed the burgeoning crisis in an interview with CBS News.
"We had not seen any videotape of what occurred in the elevator."
Still, a torrent of headlines from around the country today are calling for Goodell to go.
"The NFL was not thinking about women first. The NFL was not thinking about domestic violence first. The NFL was thinking about business and the law first, and as a result, they're in big, big trouble."
The NFL has spent millions marketing the game to gain more female fans, now 45% of the total fan base. Many of them now say they are fans no more.
"The NFL is so big and so powerful, it took their own fans to bring them around to the realization that they had really messed this up badly. They're going to have to take leadership on this issue to win those fans back."
Now, former Baltimore Raven Ray Rice broke his silence today, issuing a statement saying he has to stay strong for his family. He also told NBC News that he's hired a public relations firm and will have more to say later when he says he feels the time is right.